السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. This is Hani Ismail from Planning Engineer website. This video question is very interesting. I received one question from our colleague. He is asking about the material submission and approval. The question has two parts. First part is the submission and approval of materials. Second part is materials delivery. So I find this question is useful to our planning engineers. So I decided to record a video showing how I answered this question. The first part is asking, if we submit the material, we consider the activity has completed and waiting for the approval, but we have received revised and resubmit status. How to consider the situation? This is very smart question. Usually we put 100% whenever we submit the shop drawing or the material, which is not correct. I'll tell you in a second how to do it in the correct way. The second part is asking, after approval of material, we placed the order. One of our long lead item has 86 days. How to update this progress in every week for the weekly report? So let's go and see. I have created here a very basic time schedule for the engineering. I have the first part here is the shop drawing submittal, shop drawing approval. The second part is related to the material, where we have material submittals, material approval, material procurement, and material delivery to the site. Before telling you how to update this one, I just need to tell you one thing to consider while creating the relationships between the materials and the shop drawings. For example, this ceramic tiles materials, we submitted first, then we get the approval, and after we get the approval only, we can proceed and submit the shop drawings, okay, because the size of the tiles and the specs of the tiles will be required while creating the shop drawings. So in that case, we need to have our material approved first, then we can submit the shop drawing and proceed to the approval. However, once we have the approval of the material, we can proceed with the procurement. Then we will have a period for the delivery. You need to know the delivery period, whether your material are coming from abroad or it is local material. Then we have the construction, which is linked to the material delivery and linked to the shop drawings approval. Okay, now when we update this schedule, we do the following. Let's say our data date is 3rd September 2022, okay, and here we are doing the first update, which is 10th September. In 10th September we submitted the ceramic tiles materials. So in that case, we are going to update our schedule and put the start date 3rd September. But here we will note the percentage 100% because it is not correct. As our colleague said, we might get review and resubmit. So normally I'm putting 50% only, and I wait until I receive the reply from the consultant. Now I will update for the second week, which is 17 September. And let's say I receive revise and resubmit by 11th of September. So in that case, I'm going to the approvals in the start date, 11th of September, okay. And here I'll put 50% in the approval. Now I don't have neither the submittal nor the approval completed 100% because I'm not getting yet the code B or code A for the material. Now let's say that we resubmitted this drawing again on 13 September. So I'm going to increase the submittal percentage to 75, for example, and I will wait for the engineer response. Let's say by 24 September the engineer give me the approval. So here 24, I'll make it 100% as approval, and then 13 September, the last submittal date, I'll put it as the finish date for the submittal, which was when I get the approval for it. So this is the correct way to do the submittal and approval. If you don't have activities for first submittal, then second submittal, sometimes for the important activities, we need to put ceramic tiles, for example, first submission, ceramic tiles, second submissions, and first review, second review, and so on. Now we updated the material submittal, and we can do the same for the shop drawings, submittals, and approval. Now I received the material by 24 September, so I submitted my shop drawing on 24 September. I will give it as 50%. Okay, then in the next week, okay, which is 1st October, let's say that I received the consultant response by 26 September. And we got the could be from the first time. So in that case, I'm going to finish it also in 26 September. And I will finish the submittal on 26 September as well. There are different schools in this update method, but this is the way I'm doing it in my time schedules. And of course, you need to agree with your consultant about the way you are going to update such things. Okay, coming back to the second part of the question. Now, Yahani, I submitted and I got the material approved, and I started the procurement, and this information you need to get from your procurement department. I started it in 24th of September. Okay. The question was, okay, how I put the percentage here? Actually, I don't put the percentage here. Instead, I'm asking my procurement department, when you are expecting the manufacturer will be completed? And I put here the forecast date, and the percentage will be calculated automatically. For example, let's say our procurement department said, okay, we are expecting to get this material manufacturer to be completed by end of October for this update. So I'm going to here, I will make it by end of October. As you can see here, the percentage is updated automatically. Now let's say the second update, okay, the second update, I will ask the same question. When you, still we are on the 1st October for the delivery, they will say, no, we are moved by one day. We are expecting to have this manufacturer to be completed by 1st November. So here simply I'm going and updating it to 1st November. Second update or third update, I can ask the same question. If it is important activity, by the way, and you might do this update by you don't have enough information every week, you might have it every 2 weeks. So according to the information you have, you can update only the forecast finish date. Let's say we are expecting 1 week of delay, so I'm going to make it 8 November or let's say 6 November. As you can see, the actual percentage is updated automatically, and this is the most accurate way of updating the procurement, shop drawings, and materials. I hope you will find this video useful to you. See you in the next one.